Hello everyone, welcome to the chapter 1 of cardiovascular system. Cardiovascular system, also the circulatory system. Here cardio refers to the heart and vascular refers to the capillaries, arteries and veins in our body. Both together, the heart and the vessels together form the circulatory system. Vessels such as arteries and veins carry to and fro the necessary nutrients and gases such as oxygen from heart to organs and carbon dioxide from organs to the heart. So in this series we will be learning all about anatomy, physiology, pathology and clinical aspect related to the cardiovascular system. Let's begin with the anatomy. Let's understand where the heart is placed in a body. It is placed in the upper cavity of the body, that is the thorax. It is placed centrally in the mediastinum, but it is slightly shifted or tilted towards the left side, and it is sandwiched between the two lungs, and it is placed on a muscle which is the primary muscle which is important for breathing, that is the diaphragm. And the anterior side, it has a plate called a bony plate called the sternum. On posterior side, it lies in front of the vertebrae, and lastly are ribs. Heart is covered with a layer or a sac called as pericardium. Here you can see it has two layers, the outer layer which is called the parietal layer. It is attached to a fibrous pericardium, which is very fibrous, and it holds the heart into place and doesn't allow excessive fluid collection in the pericardium space. And the inner layer is called the visceral layer, which is attached to the surface of the heart, which forms the epicardium. Both the parietal layer and the visceral layer, these secrete a fluid which is protein-rich fluid, which helps the heart, which acts as a lubricant so that the heart can move little bit while it pumps the blood. It also helps to avoid the friction. Now we come to the layers of the heart. As we saw, the epicardium is the outer layer of the heart. The next layer is the myocardium, which is made up of striated muscles. These muscles are very important for the contraction and relaxation during each beat of the heart. And the inner layer, which is a thin endothelium cells made up of endothelium cells, it is called as endocardium. So the three layers of the heart are the epicardium, myocardium and endocardium. Here you can see some of the vessels to supply these muscles so that they can pump properly with lots of muscular effort. So these vessels are called as coronary vessels. So we understood here about the pericardium and about the layers of the heart. Let's see the inside of the heart. Heart has four chambers, namely the right atrium, the left atrium, and the right ventricle and the left ventricle. As you can see in the figure, the right atrium, these are the both upper parts are the atriums, and the lower chambers are called the ventricles. Now what happens here is the blood, the deoxygenated blood which is collected from the all the organs are collected into the right atrium. Here you can see the superior vena cava and the inferior vena cava, which bring the blood from superior and the inferior parts to the atrium. And again, when we can see, there is a opening of the coronary sinus. The coronary arteries which supply the heart are also opened here. These all together, they are pumped into the ventricles. Here you can see a valve. Totally, heart has four valves. So the tricuspid valve is between the right atrium and the right ventricle. This is tricuspid valve, and it is called tricuspid because it has three cusps or the flaps. Next is the pulmonary. Pulmonary valve is between the right ventricle and the pulmonary arteries. So here the blood is taken from the right ventricle to the lungs. Next is the mitral valve, which is between the left atrium and the left ventricle. It is also called as bicuspid valve because it has only two cusps. And fourth one is the aortic valve, which is between the left ventricle and the aorta, which sends blood to the whole system. So, namely, the four valves are the tricuspid valve, pulmonary valve, mitral valve, and the aortic valve. The atrioventricular valves among these are the valves between the atrium and the ventricle. Here the tricuspid valve is the atrioventricular valve and the mitral valve is the atrioventricular valve. So these atrioventricular valves, these have flaps, and these are maintained or held by the tendons in the heart itself called the chordae tendinae, and these are held by the small muscles inside the chambers called the papillary muscles. These help to hold the valves closed, so that whenever there is a closure of the valves, the regurgitation of the blood doesn't take place. But how the circulation or exchange of gases takes place? As we saw, the deoxygenated blood from the whole body is collected into the right atrium from superior vena cava and inferior vena cava. Here the blood is transferred to the right ventricle, through which it goes from the pulmonary arteries into the lungs. In lungs, there are structures called the alveolar structures, which are responsible for exchange of gases. Capillaries, here the deoxygenated blood, here the carbon dioxide is taken up by the alveolar and is ejected to expiration, and oxygen is absorbed into the capillaries and it is reached to the pulmonary veins, to the left atrium, through the left ventricle, and to the system to supply oxygen. So mainly this is the system of pulmonary circulation that takes place. In the first video, we understood some of the basic structures, such as structure and few of the parts and some of the very basic things about the cardiovascular system or the heart. In our coming videos, that will be the next part, we will study more about the anatomy and physiology of cardiovascular system. Thank you for watching the video.